He could slaughter a million Aishas for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never mind Abdurrahman's and Aishas. He could sacrifice his life again and again and again and again for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such was the love that he had for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu would say, he would say, لَلَيْلَةٌ مِّنْ أَبِي بَكَرْ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ آلِ عُمَرٍ وَلَيَوْمٌ مِّنْ أَبِي بَكَرْ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ آلِ عُمَرٍ He would say that just one night of Abu Bakr's life, one night of Abu Bakr's life, this was the testimony of Umar. And Umar was not your ordinary companion. The Ashri Mubashara, the second Khalifa of Islam. He's saying one night of Abu Bakr was better than Umar and the entire family of Umar. And he would say, you know, one day of Umar was better, one day of Abu Bakr was better than Umar and the entire family of Umar. And the night that he would refer to is the night when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated from Makkah to Medina with Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And he himself narrates, when Abu Bakr left with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr would walk behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after a short while, he would run and walk right in front of Rasulullah. Then he would come back. And like this, he would run to the front. And when this happened a few times, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, Ya Abu Bakr, oh Abu Bakr, why is it? تمشي ساعد خلفي وساعة بين يدي. Why is it for a short time you walk behind, then all of a sudden you run to the front and you walk in front, and then you run behind and run in front? So he explains to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, I walk behind you because I know the kuffar will be following us and hunting us. I walk behind you so that they can't attack you from behind, and I will rise to their challenge and I will fight them and protect your blessed self. But a messenger of Allah, when I'm walking behind, all of a sudden the thought crosses my mind that not only will they be coming from behind, some will be taking a different route and they will be waiting in front. So messenger of Allah, when this thought crosses my mind, I can't tolerate it. I run to the front so that they're not able to attack you and I can protect you from in front. Like this, he gets to the cave, Ghari Thawr. And when he gets to the cave, he tells Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and questions, Ya Rasulullah, please wait outside for a short while. He enters and he cleans the cave to the best of his ability. Best of his ability. Any hole that he can see which is visible, he closes the hole, fearing that there may be a snake inside here, there may be a scorpion inside here which may harm and bite Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to the best of his ability, when he thinks that the cave is clean and all the holes are now, you know, closed, he calls Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has entered. They've been traveling the whole night. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is tired. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to rest. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam places his head in the lap of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is resting. Now, according to the hadith which Tabrani has narrated on the authority of Asma, you know, while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is resting in his lap, his eyes fall upon a hole which he forgot to close. Now, fearing that maybe something inside this, what if there's a snake, a scorpion, and it comes bite Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is he going to do? Now, what is he to do? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in his lap. He can't wake Rasulullah. You know, for Abu Bakr, death was far simpler than to give taklif to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if it was for a second. So what he does while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's head in his lap, his only means is to extend his feet. And he places the heel of his foot on the mouth of the hole. And you know, just as he feared, there was a snake inside that hole. And as soon as he placed his foot, the snake bit him. And now Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu is in pain. Snake bite. He's in pain. The pain is intolerable. And the, you know, poison is spreading within the blood. What is he to do? You know, he only has two choices. Choice number one, he can look for a cure and wake Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up. But if he does this, he will have disturbed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from his sleep. And choice number two is, he can sit there. He can tolerate the pain and not move, not even a millimeter, and there wait for death and die while Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in his lap. What do you think he chose to do? What do the books of history, what have the books of history recorded? Never mind one life, he could sacrifice a million lives. For him to die was far easier than to wake Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to disturb him from his sleep. So he sat there, tolerating the pain. My friends, tolerating the pain. He's sitting there now, tolerating the pain. And you know what? The thought must have crossed his mind. Okay, now Abu Bakr is going to meet his end. And he's not even in a position to wake Muhammad and say farewell and say bye-bye. And when this thought of separation crosses his mind, a tear falls from his eyes and lands on the blessed face of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wakes up. And when he sees Abu Bakr in this pain, asks, okay, Abu Bakr, what is the matter? He says, may my parents be sacrificed on you. Ya Rasulullah, a snake has bitten me. There and then Rasulullah places his saliva on where the snake bite was. And within a second, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was cured. In another narration, it is mentioned that when Abu Bakr, when they were in the cave, Abu Bakr could actually see the kuffar. And with tears flowing from eyes, Rasulullah was in prayer at the time. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished prayer, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm not crying for myself, O Messenger of Allah, that they will harm me. O Messenger of Allah, I cannot tolerate them troubling you in my presence. In another narration, he mentioned to Nabi Karim, Ya Rasulullah, you know, the most that will happen is Abu Bakr will be killed. And as a result, my family will cry for a few days and they will overcome this. O Messenger of Allah, if harm comes to you, I fear that Allah will destroy the entire ummah. And this is when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Abu Bakr, La tahzan inna Allah ma'ana Abu Bakr, you've got nothing to fear about. Allah subhanahu